Hey golfers, it's Thomas Campbell, Master Club Fitter at Second Swing. Today I'm going to talk about the five most important fitting parameters that you look at in a club fitting. So these five most important factors are ball speed, spin rate, landing angle, carry distance, and dispersion. I'll also add in a little bonus on dynamic loft as well here too. The reason why dynamic loft is a bonus is it pertains to the golf swing. Now, in club fittings, we don't really go through a lesson. We're just focusing on the ball data. We're talking about the data that you are presenting us on TrackMan. There are so many other variables on TrackMan that you can definitely focus on, but these five factors that I just explained and we're going to cover today are the most important ones to focus on. So to outline these five most important fitting factors is I'm gonna go grab in the store a few different 7-irons and we're gonna talk about the differences in this data. We're gonna talk about ball speed, but comparing them. We're gonna talk about spin. We're gonna talk about landing angle. We're gonna talk about carry distance. And then we're gonna focus on that dispersion pattern because in the day we wanna make sure that we are hitting our irons accurately. And that is very, very important there too. Okay, so I just grabbed five different 7-irons. Now, keep in mind, as we're talking about the data here, this is not a club comparison. So one club is not gonna be performing better than the other because one club is better or not. All I'm trying to do is I'm trying to talk about data differences to explain our five most important parameters that we look at in an iron fitting. So focus on the numbers, don't focus so much on which club is performing better. It's all about the numbers. Okay, so let's take a look at these five factors. Keep in mind, I only selected five factors because sometimes fittings can get a little bit intimidating. There's a lot of numbers up there. You're in a closed off environment with a fitter, maybe a little nervous. You really want to simplify this. Just want to make sure you understand what numbers to really kind of focus on. Also, keep in mind, I purposely hit some clubs better than others. Not intentionally a specific brand, I wanted to show the dispersion pattern and explain differences. Think of these clubs as club 1 through club 5. So I hit 25 shots, let's take a look at numbers that we want to make sure we look at in a club fitting. So first, let's take a look at ball speed. So ball speed is the first factor we want to focus on. We have a range. We have a range from about 113.7 all the way up to 124.6. So with ball speed, the higher the ball speed, the further the ball can go. The reason why I didn't bring up club speed or smash factor in the iron fitting is because club speed, we all know we're gonna swing it pretty similar across the board there. And with regards to smash factor that is ball speed divided by club speed, it can be a little bit different depending on the technology that you're using. I have noticed that TrackMan, for example, picks up swing speed just a little bit slower than Foresight GC Quad can. That's why ball speed is the number one factor to focus on. Always focus on ball speed when you're looking at those numbers to see which club performed the best. So we can notice here that the 718 CB when I was hitting these five shots, the purple numbers gave us the highest ball speed. So that one performed kind of the best of the shots that I hit here. Next number we look at is spin rate. So we need spin so the ball can stop on the green. We don't want to have so little spin that the ball is going to go really, really far and not give you a chance to stop the ball on the green. And that's kind of where the landing angle comes in a little bit here too, and we'll focus on that. But spin rate. So spin rate, that's the amount the ball is spinning in RPMs. So if we take a look at the spin rate, we hit kind of a wide range from about 4125 was kind of the lowest spin rate, all the way up to 5403. So if we look here, the X-Forge CB, the yellow numbers, that one gave us the highest spin rate, so the highest ability to stop the ball on the green through spin. Next up is carry distance. So carry distance is important with an iron rather than total distance. Think you're on the golf course, imagine you have like a bunker or some water to cover. You want to make sure you have the ability to carry the ball and know how far it's going to carry rather than your total run out. A lot of the times players really focus on the total distance with a 7-iron, when really we want to make sure that we know the carry distance with our irons, so we know exactly where the ball is going to land. So if we take a look here at carry distance, I always like to look at carry distance and see which one is carrying the most consistent across the board. So I like to look at the kind of the plus or minus numbers. So if we look here at carry distance, we can see the 718 CB, the carry distance numbers are plus or minus 1.8. That's telling me, one, the carry distance was the highest at 183.9, but it also was the most consistent there as well. So that would be one of the top front runners in my mind right off the bat with regards to a club fitting, because one, it was carrying the furthest, and two, it was the most consistent. Consistency is very, very important. So the next number we look at is landing angle. So landing angle is very important. Landing angle correlates very closely with the height that you hit your club. The higher you hit the club, the steeper it's going to come to the ground and stop on the green for you there as well. So that really helps to separate your carry to total distance. If you have a steeper landing angle with an iron, it's going to stop faster on the green. If you have a much shallower landing angle with an iron, is going to take a lot longer for that ball to stop rolling out. So let's kind of look at the wide range here. So we can notice here, for example, the Ping G400, the landing angle on that was 41.8. That one's going to come in a little bit lower, and it's going to take a lot longer for that to stop. So that's going to carry about 168 yards, but it's going to roll out probably a good 20 yards. If we look up further here, we look at, for example, the X-Forged CB. The landing angle was 47.4. So that carry distance at 177.8 is then going to stop faster. So that's going to stop within about 8 to 10 yards. So it's going to give you a better chance to land the ball on the green and then stop on the green as well, especially if you have firmer greens. If you have firm greens, you need to have that landing angle to help you out a lot there as well. So landing angle, that is very, very important. Number I always like to kind of pay attention to is 45 degrees. 45 degrees is a good kind of ballpark. If that number starts getting kind of below 45 degrees with your 7-iron, we definitely want to maybe consider in your longer irons possibility of playing a hybrid. So 45 degrees is a good kind of number for a 7-iron to kind of focus yourself on. Anything over that for sure is going to give you adequate stopping power. If it starts getting under that, and especially if it starts getting under 40 degrees, especially with an iron, you want that landing angle. But try and get that landing angle up just a little bit higher if you can. So the fifth factor that we like to look at is probably the most important number. That is dispersion. In the day, we want to make sure that we are hitting the ball where we want it to go. So I always like to take a look at circles, and I always like to ask a customer, hey, which circle do you like better? Which circle kind of looks better up there on the screen? Well, if we were going to look up here on the right there, you can see how this orange circle, for example, you can see that very, very large circle. That would probably be the first club that I would eliminate out of a club fitting, because we know we didn't hit it very well. It's great that you hit the ball far. It's great you hit the ball far on your good shots, but consistency with an iron is very, very important. So we want to make sure we find a club that's very, very consistent. So speaking of consistency, so once again, I would like to look at the dispersion pattern. I would ask a customer, hey, kind of which circle is the smallest circle up on the screen? You can see, for example, that purple circle. Notice how close those five dots are together. So that shows consistency. Not only was that circle consistent, but it also was going further, but it was also going further and it was right up the middle of the screen too. So we want to make sure that we are, one, close to the middle, two, if we can get a little bit further and a little more distance, that is definitely a bonus. And three, we want to make sure that the consistency from east to west is pretty good. So we don't want to have a large range in carry distance. We want to have more of a range in carry distance from kind of left to right. So if you pull a shot, you want to make sure that ball is not going to fly over the green by 10, 15 yards. If you fade the shot, you don't want to make sure that thing's going to end up in the water just right of the green there as well. So you want to make sure that everything is kind of nice and consistent across the board. I also want to add in one extra factor to focus on. Now, the reason why this is more of a bonus number is because this is related to teaching. This is, club fitting and teaching, they are quite close together, but when we fit, we're not going to spend 45 minutes on a lesson at second swing. We're going to fit the player for their particular golf swing tendencies. So, speaking on tenancies. So there is quite the tendency with regards to dynamic loft, so how a player compresses the ball. There are many ways as a club fitter to help a player with their dynamic loft without even going down the route of even touching the lesson route. One way to do with that is to do with the loft on the club. So with 7 irons, there is quite the range. So your more game improvement 7 iron is going to have less loft on it. It's designed that way to help a player get in a more optimal performance characteristic for a 7 iron. It's not designed to go 200 yards. Now, you have a player like myself, I'm going to carry that 7 iron 200 yards that has 26 degrees of loft on it. There's no doubt about that. But a lot of players, they struggle. They really kind of struggle. And these clubs are designed to help with the center of gravity, get that ball up in the air, get the ball to kind of carry a little bit further and give you a little more distance. But if you don't compress the ball very well and you're not really interested in taking lessons, we're probably going to fit you into a club that's going to give you a little better chance to be in the better optimal window with regards to your carry distance, with regards to your spin, with regards to your height and everything like that. And that's how we really kind of help. And that's why all the manufacturers have different models out there. And that's kind of related to kind of dynamic loft. So we take a look here, you can see dynamic loft. I have a range from about 17 degrees to about 22 degrees. Now, a lot of testing when I hit my 7 iron, my dynamic loft is always kind of around about 20 to 22 degrees, and that's because I compress the ball. A lot of players, pay attention to that number. If that number is closer to 30 degrees, we know you're not compressing the ball very well. And if you're coming in with irons that are 20 years old, maybe blades, you're not hitting them very well, we may fit you into a little bit more forgiving golf club. The loft on that club may be several degrees stronger, but that's also that 7 degrees stronger is going to bring down that dynamic loft by about 7 degrees as well. So it's going to get you in a better optimal window with regards to kind of dynamic loft. So in conclusion, I provided you our 5 most important fitting parameters that we like to look at in an iron fitting. I also gave you that bonus of dynamic loft. That's important to focus on with your instructor. As a fitter, we can definitely help you with regards to the loft on the iron, but it's important to kind of focus on those other 5 factors because they are the most important factors that we want to look at. So make sure you come in to Second Swing to work with a club fitter in our store or even online at secondswing.com. We can definitely help you to get you in the right fitting optimal window for regards to numbers, and we can definitely help you find the best clubs that work for you. Thanks for watching today.